Hello, welcome to the second edition of my hat video. These are the featured hats. They have one design, and the only difference is the width of the brim. For the gray hat, I decided to make a wider brim, and for the beige hat, I tried to knit a hat using just under one ball of yarn, so the brim is shorter. I wanted to show you how the hat looks on me in motion, so to speak. So I included this part in the video that you can see how it looks from different sides. The hat has a pointy top. And this is the beige hat. The brim is shorter. I also made a matching scarf to go with the hat, and I made a set for my husband. After finishing, the hat is turned inside out, and that side becomes the right side of the hat. For casting on and a jogless connection in a circle, please watch my video. That video explains this method with a very good stitch definition, and I wanted to avoid repetition. I cast on 120 stitches, and then knit 65 rows in the round for the gray hat and 57 for the beige, and then placed the markers. The markers placement is the most important part to make this work. I have 4 short and 4 long sections, the short sections end with purl stitches and the long sections end with knit stitches. I'm placing the yellow marker of the beginning of the row. The first stitch of the row is a purl stitch. And I'm counting 5 stitches to the left of the marker. And placing the first orange marker of a short section. So the short section ends with a purl stitch. This is very important. And I'll just move my marker onto the left needle and count 6 stitches to the right of the marker and place another orange marker of the short section. And again, you see the short section on the other side ends with a purl stitch. I'm just securing the marker of the beginning of the row, and we'll place another marker. So this is the beginning of the long section, and of course it starts with a knit stitch. I'm counting 19 stitches of the long section. Here and placing my purple marker. This is the long section and it has knit stitches on both sides. Now the next short section, again it's 11 stitches. Here. And I'll place another purple marker. Just like in the diagram, I color coded the diagram using the same colors as in my markers. So the short section ends with purl stitches. And again, I'm counting 19 stitches of the long section. And place an orange marker. And another 11 stitches of a short section. This section is going to be the front of the hat, the front section of the hat. And the section has two purl stitches on the sides. Again, 19 stitches of the long section. Eleven stitches of the last short section. Purl stitches on the sides of the short sections and the long sections end with knit stitches. I'm going to decrease the stitches in the long sections before and after the marker of a short section. The following video includes only the rows with the decreases, which I alternate with the rows without. At this point, I also switch to the magic loop technique, and you can use magic loop or double point needles, whichever you find more convenient for yourself. But if you're interested how I do it with a magic loop, then this part of the video is for you. I tighten the first stitch a little bit. So I finished the short section, and here I'm going to make a first decrease, and I slip two stitches knitwise and then knit them together. the next decrease is going to be before the following short section. And here I simply need two stitches together. Here I finished knitting the short section, and I'm going to again decrease by slipping two stitches knitwise and knitting them together. The next decrease is going to be just before the marker of the following short section. And I simply knit these two stitches together. Again, the next decrease is going to be after the marker of a short section. Slip two stitches knitwise and knit them together. The next decrease again before the marker of a following short section. We knit two together. And after the marker of the short section, again, slip two stitches knitwise and knit them together. And this is the last decrease before a marker of the short section. Here I'm almost done with my short circular needle and switched to the long one. So I'm switching to the magic loop. My needle has a very long cable and I'm going to pull it out. From the sides. This way your changeover points are on the sides, so in case of a baggy stitch, it's not going to be very noticeable. I will continue decreasing in the long sections. so that my long sections will eventually come to an end. And for now, the short sections are knit straight. I recorded another row with the decreases because the stitches look a little bit different here. Now we have two knit stitches on either side of the long sections. And also I wanted to show you how I knit using magic loop. Here we again slip two stitches knitwise and knit them together. That's the first decrease of a long section. And then at the end of the long section, we'll knit two together. This is the end of the long section before the marker of a short section, and simply knit two together. I will continue until the changeover point because I wanted to show you how I use the magic loop technique for making this hat. I reached the changeover point and I'm going to pull out the cord of the left needle tip. So my left needle goes in and I'm pulling the right needle tip out. And there you go. I can continue. My next decrease is going to be here. And I continue knitting my rib. My first stitch here is a purl stitch. So I purl it. And it's important to tighten this area a bit to avoid a baggy collar. Again, we slip two stitches knitwise and knit them together. The following decrease is before the next short section. Knit two together. And another decrease after the short section. Again, slip. Slip, knit two together, next two decreases again before a marker of a short section and after. Here again, I knit two together before the marker. Here I'm approaching another changeover point. And again, I'm pulling out the cord of my left needle tip. So my left hand needle tip goes in. And the right hand needle tip comes out. This is the area where I'm going to do another decrease. This is a purl stitch. I purl it and I tighten this area a bit just to make sure I will not have baggy stitches. Here again, slip, and knit two stitches together. And I have one more decrease, one last one, before the next short section. Here it is, and it's a simple knit two stitches together. Continue decreasing until you have 3 stitches left of the long sections. The long sections are now down to 3 stitches. And I will show you how to continue decreasing. These are the last 3 stitches. I'm removing the markers. We will not need them anymore. There is a purl and a knit stitch to the right of the central purl stitch, and I'm going to purl them together. And then purl the central purl stitch. And I'm going to swap the positions of these 2 stitches. I slip off the first knit stitch. and then slip the purl stitch, and the knit stitch goes back on the left needle. Followed by the purl stitch. I need to have a continuous row of the knit stitches on the other side. And I purl them together. I have 3 purl stitches now and 3 continuous rows of knit stitches on the other side. In the next row with the decreases, where I have 3 purl stitches, I'm going to purl a purl and a knit stitch that are positioned before those 3 purl stitches, like this. Then I will purl the next stitch and the one after that. And the third purl stitch, I will purl together with the following knit stitch. And a regular purl stitch. Now I have 5 purl stitches. In the next row with the decreases, I purl together a purl and a knit stitch before my 5 purl stitches. Then purl the following 4 purl stitches. And the 5th purl stitch, I purl together with the following knit stitch. And purl the following regular stitch. Now I have 7 purl stitches in this section. At this moment, I have 4 sections of 7 purl stitches divided by single knit stitches, altogether 32 stitches. In the next row, I will decrease the purl stitches only and continue to knit the single knit stitches. So here are my 7 purl stitches. I place a marker on the central stitch and I'm going to decrease right before and right after this central stitch, and I'll show you how. Before the marker, I'm going to swap the positions of the purl stitches. And purl them together. After the marker, I simply purl 2 stitches together. Now I have 5 purl stitches left in this area. And this is how it looks on the other side, which is going to be the right side. We have symmetrical decreases and continuous knit stitch rows. This is the last row with the decreases. Again, I place a marker on the central stitch. This is the first decrease. I slip the first stitch and then the second. Return the first stitch back onto the left needle tip and return the other stitch back onto the left needle tip and purl them together. And these purl stitches I simply purl together. Now I have 3 purl stitches left. And altogether, I have 4 sections of 3 purl stitches divided by single knit stitches. In total, 16 stitches. And after one more row without the decreases, I'm finished. It's handy to keep the marker of the beginning of the row because I will know in which way to hide the yarn tail. It's better to hide it at the back of the hat. And this is how the finished hat looks at the back and at the front. And this is the side that we see as we need. And I turn it inside out. And this is the actual right side of the hat. And we have continuous rows of knit stitches to the very top of the hat. This is how I shape the top of the hat after washing. I stretch a bit the former long sections and keep the central short section as straight as possible. And make sure that the edge looks also as neat as possible. And 24 hours later, while the hat is still done, I fold it also to shape the brim a bit, and I press on the brim a little bit with my hands for a crisper look. And also on the other side. And this is how the gray hat looks after washing and shaping, and the beige hat before washing, and after washing and shaping.